Hi, I'm Ryan Kliethermes with KE2 Therm. The need to bond controllers with different versions of our firmware or simply the desire to use new features found in newer firmware requires the user to update or bootload the controller's firmware. So let's take a look at how this is done. And keep in mind while we are showing you the process on a KE2 Evap controller, it is the same procedure for KE2 Therm's other Ethernet-based controllers like the KE2 Evap for rack efficiency and the controlled environment. Just be sure to select the appropriate firmware for your controller. Before we start, let's get organized. You will need the controller you want to update, 110 or 220 volt power source, a computer, and an Ethernet cable. Then go to the KE2 Therm website at ketotherm.com, scroll down to the menus at the bottom of the home page, and click on Software Updates and Instructions. From here, click the download button for the version of the firmware you want. In this case, we will select version 4.8. On my computer, files are set to automatically download to the downloads folder. Find the folder for your computer and open the zip folder. Then select the extract all files option to a location of your choice. I prefer the desktop because they're easy to find. Open the folder by double-clicking and verify there are four files in the folder. Next, and this is specifically because you are direct connecting, you will need to set your computer's IP address to static. If you are not familiar with this, see our bulletin or watch our other videos. Okay, so now that the preliminary work is complete, let's use an Ethernet cable to connect the computer to the controller's Ethernet port. Then connect the controller to a 120 or 240 volt power source. If the controller is already installed in the system, this should already be completed. If you're plugging the controller into an outlet, verify the voltage jumper is set to 120. Attach the power connector to the controller and the other end of the power cord into the wall socket. Again, if the controller was previously installed, this step is already completed. Now, check where you plugged in the Ethernet cable and confirm that the network link light is active on your PC. Once that is all good to go, note the IP address on the back of the controller. But remember, if the IP address was previously changed, the controller's current address must be used. The current IP address can be verified from the front panel. Use the right arrow to find the variables menu, press up arrow 10 times to get to the first octet. It will be broken down into four sections. The first set of 1 to 3 numbers are the first segment of the IP and so on. There are four segments or octets total. So once you have the IP, open a web browser on your computer and enter the controller's IP address into the address bar. This will bring up the main page of the controller. Click on the set points button to view the current system set points. We recommend snapping a screenshot of the set points and the settings pages so you can quickly reprogram the controller after bootloading the new firmware. To do this, press the alternate plus print screen keys on the keyboard or use the snipping tool, then paste this image in a Word document. Do this for all the screens you want to capture. Now, click on the setting button. Click the login to get the password screen. If the controller is using older firmware, 3.2 or older, there is only a password and the default is 2222. For versions 3.2 and newer, you'll need to use username and password. If the controller is still using the factory defaults, the username and password are both KE2 admin, all lowercase. As a side note, we recommend changing these from the default for security reasons. Okay, moving on. Click the Enter or Submit button. And we are now back on the settings page. Look at the upper right-hand corner of the page for the current firmware version number. Click the bootloader button. If a verification button pops up, click yes. The controller is now in bootloader mode and BTLM is displayed on the front of the controller. On later versions of the web page, displays a red background and indicates bootloader mode. Open the update application and click Find All Devices. The IP address should populate the IP address field. then select Program menu and the Program option. Now let's confirm that the update was installed properly. So refresh or reload the web page on your browser. You can use Control plus F5 to make sure it loads the page properly. See on the settings page, the version number now reads 4.8. Now that we've bootloaded the controller, it is back in intro or startup mode, just like it was on a new install. Use the screenshots we captured earlier to check the default set points and settings against your required setup and make sure you make the necessary adjustments so your system runs properly. Once you are finished or if no changes are needed, click the Save on the Set Points page. The controller will begin to operate with the new firmware. If you have any questions, see our other videos or contact our tech support line.